disc, this card I'm using, which played up the other day. It's 64 gigabytes, so there should be plenty of room on it. I only used a fraction. This is Dullingham, everyone. Before we go in the church, we're just going to have a look down by the pond. I'm doing it from a slightly different angle. I cleaned all back there, look. Because these are of some I haven't seen before. I don't even know if I'm going to read them. Something rather. It is something bigger. Or bigger. anyway. This name will be inside the church. Great big slab to them. It's quite possible that we didn't. There's a marsh. I've got a feeling somewhere in the tree there's marshes. In fact, we've got loads of people. We're connected to so many people in Dullingham, and I mean, there's a Mingay there. We've got Mingays, Charles Mingay. We just take pictures of the ones. Of course, there's some oaks spelled with an E over there as well, and we've never really worked out if we're connected yet, because I haven't got around to doing it. I've got a feeling they came from the Midlands. Yeah, they've left some overgrown, haven't they? This is a little walk through. There's graves all the way along in here, by the way. Joseph Henry Moore. Yeah, Moore. These are war graves. Let's stop a minute, shall we? Outside of Dullingham at the moment. I'll do the church. It's probably open. I think there were some Isaacsons down here. Haylock again. Of course, Mark could be over there. That's the grave that Mark Oak, that Zora spent a lot of time on, is over there. He's over there, and we spent a lot of time on that one. We'll go over there in a minute. For 5 or 6 years. I don't always stop at Dullingham, you see. Once I found Dullum. Right, now, here we go. There's an oak grave stuck in the tree. But it does look quite clear, like someone's tidied it. John Oakes, the sacred to the memory of John Oakes, who departed this life at Summit Park, Hare Park, on the 15th of something, April, 1873, aged 77 years. And then there's another one, Elizabeth Oakes. Spelt with ES on the end, these ones. I got a feeling I might have looked them up, traced them to Sheffield or somewhere. We still don't know, but there was a, in Bury St Edmunds, there were some oaks as well. And they were bankers. They discovered the first Lloyds Bank, that oak group. I think it was a Lloyds Bank. It had an oak symbol in the beginning. There's more than one there. That's just one. In the tree. I don't know if this is it, who this is. Let's just check this one out. This was a big one once. Was it? Yeah. I thought there was more than one oak grave here. There's Ingrams. Well, I think we make note of the Ingrams because they could be connected to the oaks. Do you know what I mean? Could be associated, but there was, I'm sure there was more than one grave here. Yeah, they were around that plot there. The old photos will show it. Yeah, there was more than one grave there. Some Isaacsons here in a row here. I don't know if I found the connection to them yet, but they were a lot clearer than the Pleurococcus and the Calaplaca. So that's one here, I think. This is John Isaacs, and this one, because I've got it a lot clearer. I think there were others. In the past, just trying to see if some are missing now. They've deteriorated. And, right. But we know they're buried here, even if their grave's not visible. Under the oak tree, look. He isn't even planted under an oak, is he? So there's another one over there. So it's just a scan round. Now we'll go back up. So I've had a look at all those over there. Oh, I've really got bad shoulder ache from carrying the heavy bag. Do you know, everyone knows if when you hit a village, word goes out, it's neighbourhood watch. It's really hot in villages. You might not know, but they got eyes everywhere, and they phone each other and pass on the information. There's a woman going around photographing the graves. Could be said, you see, because they get their lead nicked. Dullingham did, and they did it in plain public view. Stick the scaffolding up, said they were doing roof repairs. I just got to turn off the camera on the video for a minute in case it suddenly turns itself off and we lose the video. So I'll put it off.